Imagine the ground shaking with a force 44,700 times stronger than one of the most closely watched volcanoes in the world. That's exactly what happened in Myanmar. Italy's Campi Flegrei has kept its scientists and locals on edge for years with its volcanic activity. The recent earthquake in Myanmar has stolen the spotlight with its jaw-dropping power. This wasn't just a typical tremor. It released energy on a scale that's almost hard to imagine. Let's compare how powerful the Myanmar earthquake was as compared to Campi Flegrei. If you want to know more about Campi Flegrei and why it's powerful, be sure to watch our other video on Campi Flegrei. And don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon so you can keep up with the recent changes in Earth's tectonic plates. In the picturesque landscape west of Naples lies a sleeping giant, the Campi Flegrei of the Phlegraean Fields, a vast caldera volcano. This sprawling volcanic field has been active for over 80,000 years, pockmarked by craters, bubbling lakes, and fumaroles venting sulfurous steam. Campi Flegrei is often dubbed a supervolcano for its immense potential. It once unleashed one of the largest volcanic eruptions in Europe's last 200 millennia, and its massive ancient blasts helped shape the region's history and geology. Late in 2024, the people around Naples began feeling the ground quiver beneath their feet with unsettling frequency. Campi Flegrei was experiencing an intense swarm of earthquakes, a frenzy of tremors caused by magma and gases straining the crust. In fact, a record 6,740 earthquakes were recorded in the Campi Flegrei area over the course of 2024. Most of these earthquakes were tiny, barely noticeable by anyone. But as the year went on, the quakes grew more frequent and stronger, a sign that pressure was building beneath the caldera. Then, on May 20, 2024, shortly after midnight, the restless ground delivered a sharp jolt. A magnitude 4.4 earthquake struck near the coastal city of Pozzuoli. It was the strongest quake in the Campi Flegrei region in 40 years. Over the next day, more than 150 smaller aftershocks rattled the area in the wake of the 4.4 tremor. Schools in several towns were closed as a precaution. The authorities even began rehearsing emergency plans, conducting large-scale evacuation drills in case Campi Flegrei's unrest escalated into a full-blown eruption. Half a world away from Italy's restless caldera, another part of Earth was about to remind us of the planet's ferocious power. Not through magma and ash, but through the grinding of tectonic plates. On March 28, 2025, just before 1 p.m. local time, a catastrophic magnitude 7.7 earthquake struck central Myanmar. The quake erupted deep beneath the Sagaing region, perilously close to Mandalay, Myanmar's second largest city. In an instant, centuries of pent-up stress along a major fault line released in a violent eruption. The shaking was so powerful it achieved a maximum intensity of 9, violent, on the Mercalli scale, strong enough to snap buildings like twigs. It was the most powerful earthquake to hit Myanmar in over a century, the largest since at least 1912. Those on the ground that day experienced a scene of terror. In Mandalay, midday shoppers and monks alike felt the ground convulse. Structures swayed, then started to crumble. Within less than a minute, numerous buildings had collapsed. A historic 5-story building in the city center pancaked into rubble, trapping people inside. At the busy Mandalay airport, security cameras captured chaotic footage of the tarmac rippling. Panicked travelers and staff ran as the concrete beneath them buckled. A jetliner wobbled on the shaking runway as voices cried out, "Sit down, don't run." As if one quake wasn't enough, Myanmar was hit by a strong aftershock just 12 minutes later. A magnitude 6.4 tremor jolted the region again, adding to the destruction. This 1-2 punch left residents dazed and terrified. "It was like the earth was throwing a 1-2 punch at us," said one survivor, describing the twin quakes. 6 provinces in Myanmar were declared disaster zones within hours. Communication was difficult as power outages and the country's ongoing military conflict made information scarce. Still, grim reports trickled in. In the central city of Sagaing, near the epicenter, entire villages were flattened. Further south in Yangon, high-rise buildings swayed alarmingly, prompting thousands to rush outdoors to safety. Even in neighboring countries, the earth's convulsions were felt. In Thailand's capital, Bangkok, over 1,000 kilometers away, skyscrapers shook so severely that a 33-story building under construction collapsed, killing several workers. Tremors were reported as far as the distant city of Hanoi in Vietnam. The reach of this earthquake was astonishing, a testament to its sheer force propagating through the ground. When the dust began to settle, the scale of the disaster was heartbreaking. In Myanmar, entire city blocks lay in ruins. The death toll climbed into the thousands. Over 1,600 people were confirmed killed in Myanmar within a day, and authorities feared the final count would be even higher. It became the deadliest natural disaster in Myanmar in many years. In the midst of a civil war, the country suddenly faced a humanitarian crisis triggered by nature. Roads were torn apart, and airports were shut down after runways split and control towers were damaged. All the while, aftershocks continued to rattle the region, keeping everyone on edge. This was a major geologic event, not just for Myanmar, but one of the strongest earthquakes anywhere on Earth in recent years. To grasp just how powerful the Myanmar quake was, it helps to compare it to the much smaller rumblings under Campi Flegrei. In fact, by one measure, the 2025 Myanmar earthquake was roughly 44,700 times more powerful than Campi Flegrei's 2024 earthquake. How on earth is that possible? Well, let's dig into the science. At first glance, comparing the Myanmar earthquake to Campi Flegrei's 4.4 tremor might seem like pitting a giant against a mouse, and in many ways, it is. Seismologists measure earthquake size using the magnitude scale, which is logarithmic. This means a small increase in magnitude number actually represents a huge jump in physical energy released. In the magnitude scale used today, the moment magnitude, similar to the older Richter scale, each whole number step represents about 31.6 times more energy released. In other words, a magnitude 5.0 quake isn't just a bit stronger than a 4.0, it releases 32 times more energy. A 6.0 is about 32 times beyond that, and a 7.0 about 1,000 times more energy than a 5.0 quake. The numbers grow staggeringly fast. By the time you jump from a moderate magnitude 4 earthquake to a major magnitude 7+, the difference in energy is tens of thousands fold. This is exactly what we saw with Campi Flegrei versus Myanmar. Campi Flegrei's notable quake in 2024 was around M4.4, enough to rattle windows and crack plaster, but relatively small in the grand scale of earthquakes. The Myanmar main shock in 2025 was an M7.7 beast, a major earthquake by any definition. The magnitude difference is about 3.3 points. It sounds like a small jump in number, but remember that each point multiplies energy 31.6 times. If you multiply that factor by itself 3.3 times over, you get an enormous ratio. Indeed, seismologists calculate that the Myanmar quake released tens of thousands of times more energy than the 4.4 tremor in Italy. Roughly speaking, 7.7 versus 4.4 corresponds to the order of 4.5 times 10 to the power of 4 times more energy, which is about 44,700 times as much. Put another way, if the Campi Flegrei quake were like the energy of a single stick of dynamite, the Myanmar earthquake was nearly 50,000 sticks going off. No wonder the effects were incomparably worse. The ground motion in Myanmar was on a different level entirely, rupturing a fault over 300 kilometers long and shaking whole cities, whereas Campi Flegrei's tiny fracture was just a pinprick by comparison. What made the Myanmar earthquake so much more energetic? Part of the answer lies in geology. Myanmar sits on the intersection of multiple tectonic plates grinding past each other. The culprit in this quake was the Sagaing FAult, a major crack in the earth that runs 1,400 kilometers through Myanmar like a tectonic zipper. This fault is a boundary between the Burma microplate and the Sunda plate, and it slowly slips a few centimeters each year. Over decades, stress builds up as the plates snag and stick until one day the fault ruptures in a violent release. The March 28 quake was the Sagaing FAult's fury made manifest. The crust tore open for about 350 kilometers in length in a strike-slip motion, releasing centuries of pent-up strain in under a minute. It was a classic tectonic mega-quake. Campi Flegrei's 4.4 quake, on the other hand, had a very different origin. It was a volcano tectonic quake, caused not by large-scale plate movement, but by the restless magma and hot fluids pushing at rocks under the caldera. Such quakes are usually shallow and of modest size, enough to alarm locals but tiny on the global seismic scale. Campi Flegrei's shake was essentially a side effect of volcanic unrest, releasing minor energy. The Myanmar quake was a titanic plate boundary event, releasing energy accumulated from the motion of whole continents. It's the difference between a local underground rumble and a full-fledged tearing of the Earth's crust. Interestingly, both types of quakes taught scientists and residents important lessons. In Italy, the 2024 swarm was a warning that even moderate tremors near a volcano can cause damage and fear, especially in a densely populated area sitting on volcanic hollow ground. In Myanmar, the 2025 quake was a harsh reminder that known faults like Sagaing can produce catastrophic earthquakes if quiet for too long. Historical records showed how many big quakes on this fault in 1930, 1946, etc., but nothing as large as 7.7 in recent memory, so many were caught unprepared. The geology of Myanmar amplified the disaster too. Soft river sediments around the cities like Mandalay and distant Bangkok intensified the shaking, acting like a bowl of jelly when the seismic waves rolled through. It might surprise you, but under the right, or rather wrong, circumstances, Campi Flegrei could unleash an event that makes even a magnitude 7.7 quake seem small. Earthquakes release kinetic energy by shaking the ground, but volcanic eruptions release other forms of energy, blasting ash, lava, and hot gases with explosive force. And Campi Flegrei is capable of truly colossal eruptions. Around 39,000 years ago, long before recorded history, Campi Flegrei erupted in one of the most cataclysmic events Europe has ever seen. This eruption, known as the Campanian Ignimbrite eruption, was so massive it earned a volcanic explosivity index, VEI, of 7, just shy of the absolute top of the scale. It was the largest explosive eruption in Europe in the past 200,000 years. Evidence from geological deposits show that this mega eruption ejected on the order of 200 cubic kilometers of molten rock and ash, enough to blanket an area the size of New Jersey under meters of ash, or to fill 80 million Olympic swimming pools. Thankfully, such eruptions are extremely rare, far rarer than giant earthquakes. The last time Campi Flegrei had a significant eruption was in 1538, a comparatively small event that formed a new hill, Monte Nuovo. The volcano has simmered down since then, and scientists are closely monitoring its every quake and sigh of gas to give warning of any impending eruption. The 2024 earthquake swarm, while scary, was a far cry from the levels of activity that would precede an actual eruption. But it served as a reminder that one day, perhaps decades or centuries from now, Campi Flegrei could awaken violently. In the end, our planet has many ways of releasing its internal energy. Sometimes it's a slip of tectonic plates, jostling our cities and remaking the land in seconds. Other times, it's the eruption of magma from the depths, unleashing ash and fire into the skies. Both are reminders that Earth is alive under our feet. By examining events like Campi Flegrei's earthquakes and the Myanmar megaquake side by side, we get a richer understanding of the forces at work and a renewed respect for the delicate human existence atop this ever-changing Earth. With that said, our prayers are with all those who are affected by the disastrous earthquake in Myanmar, and hopefully by studying such events, scientists can predict them in advance. But what do you all think? Would that even be possible? Let us know in the comments below, and check out our videos on the end screen.